Hi, everyone. I'm Jill.
And I'm Alice.
And this is
Waterfront Wednesdays,
brought to you by Boston Harbor Now. Today, we're going to talk about climate change, why it matters to Boston, and in particular, Boston Harbor.
We've noticed that a lot of jargon gets thrown around, so we're trying to tackle that.
Resilience, sustainability, sea level rise, adaptation.
They all matter, but they don't all mean the same thing.
In our work, people come to us to talk about sea level rise all the time.
Whenever there are major storms, major flooding, you get asked to be on the news.
But not everyone is speaking the same language.
We should put out up front that climate change is a really big umbrella, but it affects people really differently depending on where they live.
For example, in Boston Harbor, we are experiencing extreme storms with increased frequency. So for example, we might get a storm surge on top of a wicked high tide, and now the Harbor Walk is flooded.
But if you live further inland in Boston or just anywhere else in the United States, there's a good chance that for you, climate change has more to do with things like a really hot day or a sudden thunderstorm and a big downpour that causes unexpected flooding or even fires.
And I feel like we already got really jargony.
Yeah, let's start talking about what these words mean. Climate
versus weather.
Climate is the average temperature. It's what something is like normally, like over a 30-year period. What are the usual temperatures? What are the usual winds? What's it like at a certain time of year in that place?
Weather is what you actually see. Precipitation, clouds. It's basically what you can feel when you wake up in the morning.
And we check the weather to figure out what we're gonna do that day. But if we're packing for a trip, sometimes we know the climate and sometimes we know the weather. If you were flying to Cuba tomorrow, or I was flying off to Hawaii, we'd pack a swimsuit and a dress. That's what we expect from the climate. But probably we want to check the weather forecast, because if we're flying anywhere else, we're not sure what we're going to find when we get there.
So in other words, climate is what you expect, weather is what you actually get.
Or we plan for climate, and we live in weather.
And this is Boston, so let's use a sports analogy. Weather is any given at bat, climate is your career batting average.
The next thing to talk about, though, is climate change. This refers to any long change in the Earth's weather or in the climate of a region or city. It includes warming, cooling, changes in wind patterns.
So when you see more rain, less rain, you experience less snow, no snow, that's climate change.
The city of Boston released its Climate Ready Plan in 2015, and it was all about predicting what the future of Boston's climate was going to look like.
Next up, global warming.
This is why we care.
Global warming refers to the long-term increases of the Earth's average temperatures.
It has to do with the fact that we've been releasing lots of carbon into the atmosphere, mostly due to things that have happened since the Industrial Revolution. The question then is, how do we address that? So one option is sustainability. Sustainability is about meeting the needs of the present in ways that don't compromise the ability of the future to meet those same needs. You can do that in lots of different ways. You can just drive your car less and walk or bike more, or take the train.
So these next two terms are confused pretty often, so we're going to talk about them together.
Mitigation.
And adaptation.
Mitigation is about avoiding the unmanageable. So we can do things that allow us to mitigate against climate change, basically to reduce the amount of carbon emissions that we're putting in the atmosphere, or doing things that absorb that carbon from the atmosphere.
While adaptation is managing the unavoidable. So it's basically exactly what it sounds like. We are adapting to certain systems. So we're adapting to actual sea level rise or expected sea level rise.
Other ways that we might adapt are we maybe elevate buildings or we elevate roadways because there's just that one point of flooding that's coming into a neighborhood.
Next is everyone's favorite word,
resilience.
So resilience is the ability of a system and its all of its parts to anticipate, absorb, accommodate, or recover from the effects of climate change.
It's the ability to respond to those changing conditions, to bounce back and do things right after an event happens. So maybe there's flooding or maybe there's freezing, and it means that you can't do something on a particular day, but how quickly do you bounce back from that experience? So every piece of our built environment and the systems that we use today has some of these elements.
You've heard us talk about Harbor Walk 2.0. That's an example of resilience. So we use it when the water is low to kind of walk around and enjoy the waterfront, but when the waters come in, we can use that as a way to be more resilient and protect our waterfront.
It's also a question of adaptation. So on a day-to-day basis, we want to make sure that the same tools that we are using for resilience are allowing people to use the Harbor Walk more regularly or throughout all different periods of the tidal cycle. We could have something that just pushes the sand and water off after the storm, or we could have the thing that protects the Harbor Walk from the storm. if we think about it in terms of transportation, things like ferries are great at resiliency. Maybe you can't use it in the middle of a storm, but it allows you to use it immediately after a storm to cross in an area that might be flooded. If you're interested in the climate impacts on Boston Harbor, you in the audience, you might want to get more involved with us at Boston Harbor Now and our climate task force.
Check out the website here.
And we also want to thank the co-chair of that climate task force, Stephanie Kroll, who did some really great research on the vocabulary that we talked about today.
Thanks for tuning in.
We'll see you for the next Waterfront Wednesday.
And don't forget to follow us on Twitter, @HarborHorwood.
@FerryFerry. See you on the harbor.